In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum. Stay in the car. I'll go and ask information.
Attention, patrons. The park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience. Employees, prepare the park for shutdown.
Callum was born the day this place opened. This is his favorite place in the world.
Lorraine, don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop! I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
Wait up there for Mommy, Callum.
Come on, this way!
Callum, where are you going?
Over here!
There's something special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed. Have a safe journey home.
Here. It's easy to get lost here. Too dark. I'm not going in there without a flashlight. I think this belongs to Callum. Chad the chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit. I wonder what this is. Callum, stay where you are!
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children, a boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup. "What will become of us?" the woodcutter asked his wife one night.
"I tell you what, husband, we will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there."
"No, my wife, I cannot do that," said the man.
"Then we will all four starve, you fool."
Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep.
"Do not fret, Gretel," Hansel said. He crept out of the hut
and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets. The next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day. Clever Hansel leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods. When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house. After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. "Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself," the wife told the woodcutter. In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again. Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed. Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days. The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls. "Nibble, nibble, little mouse. Nibbling at my house." An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes. "Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me. No harm will come to you." But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. "Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you." The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat. "You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside," the old woman urged, and the children, still licking their sweets, followed. Once inside the house, the old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage and put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. "Your brother will make a good mouthful," the old witch told Gretel. "Once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him." Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. "Today I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven." But Gretel pretended not to understand.
I do not know how. Where is the opening?"
"Fool!" the old witch said. "The opening is here!"
And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward into the oven. Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled and the
witch was cooked. And then, because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.